G'day everyone, Viv here. I hope you're all keeping well. Welcome back to Knights of Dice. I will do something about the windows behind us so we don't get this issue with lighting. Anyway, time to have a look at our cardboard boxes. Before I jump into that, let me just explain, the two types of foam that we create. We can make foam to any size or shape to fit any bag or box that you have, but in terms of what we produce for our boxes and bags, we do two different size pieces of foam. This size here, the smaller one, and the larger one. On the website, we call these horizontal and vertical foam. And that has to do with how this foam is stored in our campaign case. The campaign case is the larger bag that we produce, and the trays stack into that bag this way. So when you're carrying them by the handle at the top, these trays are traveling horizontal to the ground. Versus these ones, which will go into the case like a normal, carry case, let's say a GW case, for example, they'll load in from the top. And when I turn the bag on the side to carry the handle, the trays are sitting vertically. They're the two types of foam that we produce. I'm not a massive fan of the vertical and horizontal names. That's just what we inherited when we bought Laser Touch a few years ago from the previous owners. But they're the two types of trays we make, horizontal and vertical. So when it comes to having a look at our cardboard boxes, we produce four different cardboard boxes at this stage. The smallest box is what we call Box A. Not a fantastically, imaginative name, but this is Box A. It is, and all the boxes are the same, a very similar design to a wine case. It has flaps that fold on the inside of the box and flaps that fold on the outside of the box to keep everything secure. And then a carry handle on the side here. You'll notice there's a small lip that's been cut off of the bottom here. That's just to make it easier to get your hands underneath there when the box is sitting on a table. This box will carry the horizontal trays and they'll load into the case like this. The internal dimensions of this case is 140 millimeters. So it's been designed to allow you to carry three 35 mil trays plus a topper. Before I go any further, let me just explain when I talk about depth of foam. So this tray, the pockets in this tray are 35 millimeters deep. To the base of this, we then add an 8 millimeter base layer. So you'll end up with a tray that is approximately 53 millimeters thick. Box A will hold three 35 mil trays, four 25 mil trays, or whatever combination of trays that you can fit within that 140 millimeters. Again, we produce trays in 15, 25, 35, 40, 50, and 60 mil. Plus, don't forget that 8 mil base layer. So a 60 mil tray is 68 millimeters thick. That's Box A. Box B is slightly larger, but it holds a different foam. Let's pack this one up. So Box B, this is designed to carry the vertical trays. Again, it's the same type of box design, however it's designed to carry the vertical trays. And again, same dimensions, 140 millimeters internal space, and you'll notice that there is some space around this tray to allow you to fold the wings in and maybe slip any pieces of paper that you might need to, any tokens or templates or things like that. So this will hold three 35 mil trays, 425 mil trays, or any combination that you can fit within that 140 mils. Keep in mind that you need to allow for an 8 mil topper if you want to put a topper in there. So your workable space on the inside is about 132 millimeters. That's Box B. Let's take this foam out and fold this box up and put it away. When you first get your box, you may have noticed it's a little stiff, it's a little tight. It will take a little time for the cardboard to, flex and adjust itself into, a smooth fit. So Box C. Box C will hold the horizontal trays. And it will hold trays side by side. So you can fit two trays and again, stack it up how you want. So you'll fit six 35 mil trays or eight 25 mil trays in here, or any combination in between, up to 140 mil. So let's get rid of that. That's Box C. Now the largest box, box D, this will fit either vertical or horizontal trays, but not both together. So if you use these trays, which are our standard size trays, this is generally what most people have of ours, this will fit trays in this way. And again, you know, however, you know, whatever combinations you want. You might have, you know, two 50mm trays here, three 35mm trays in the middle, and four 25mm trays on the side here. Or you could use Create-It, and I'll talk about Create-It soon, to make, you know, half trays, or some weird tray that goes along here, and a whole bunch of half trays, or any combination that you can fit inside this box. The internal dimensions are on the website for this box, for all the boxes. So you can fit the horizontal or the vertical trays in this box, and you'll fit two this way, and then, you know, again, whatever combination that you want. They're the four different boxes that we produce. This is a corrugated cardboard box. It is unwaxed. It is not designed for everyday use. It is designed for storage. We produce very high quality carry bags, but for, you know, like most people like me, and as you may have seen in various videos around the studio, we have these boxes everywhere. They're just designed for storage. Excuse me. I do carry them around. They have a very, very strong carry handle, which is held on the back here by you know, this full plastic plate. It will be very, very hard to rip this out of this box. It just, you know, it will be secure. I haven't done any pressure testing or load testing on that. Maybe we'll do that, fill up one of these with bricks and see if we can carry it. So they're the four different types of boxes that we produce. Again, it's just a corrugated cardboard box. It will fray around the edges as you open and close it, open and close it. It will fray around the edges here. It will fray around the carry handle. But for its intended purpose, primary purpose, which is storage, you know, that's not really a problem. As I mentioned previously earlier, you know, we do foam to fit any case bag or box in any size, any thickness. If we need to go deeper than the 60mm that we typically produce, we can do 75. We have that in stock. Or we start laminating up layers on top of each other. We've done massive, massive boxes for cinema cameras and lights and all that sort of stuff. So we can fit whatever you have into foam to fit whatever bag, box or case that you have. But in terms of our cardboard carry cases or the cardboard storage cases, they're the four types that we produce, and they're all available on our website now. Thanks for watching, guys. More videos coming soon. If you've got something that you want to see in a video format up close, put it in the description below or send us a message on Facebook, and you know, we'll see if and when we can slot that in. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I'll catch you next time. See ya.